Want to get the most out of your Stardew Valley playthrough? Good, because I'm going to show you exactly how to turn your playthrough into a thriving success. Alrighty, let's get started. Getting lucky rings can impact many things in many of your day-to-day activities in Stardew Valley. Your daily luck is random, and there isn't really anything we can do to influence that. But we can artificially increase our luck by eating and drinking luck-increasing food like ginger ale and a lucky lunch. These things are pretty easy to get, but you can also artificially increase your luck by wearing two lucky rings. The problem is, lucky rings are pretty hard to find. You either have to be lucky in the mines or you have to pan those sparkling spots in the water. To make finding lucky rings much easier, wait until you have the best possible luck day, a star drop day. Then eat some of your best luck boosting food and beverages and head for the dig site on Ginger Island. If you have maxed out your possible artificial luck and you are on a best possible luck day, you should have 4.9% chance of getting a lucky ring with every panning attempt that you make. The dig site is by far the best place to try your luck at finding a lucky ring because it has the highest panning spot respawn rates in the game. Every 10 in-game minutes, there's a 28% chance that a panning spot appears here, meaning you will be able to pan the entire time. And this might not be action-packed, adventurous gameplay, but it's definitely worth the effort. You will find a lucky ring here. Just keep on trying. When you finally get your lucky ring, combine it with a burglar ring at the forge at the end of the volcano dungeon. Now you are ready to conquer the valley. With the addition of the latest 1.5 update, we now have access to the volcano dungeon. And at the end of the volcano dungeon, we will find a forge. A forge that will change the way you play the game. Unfortunately, using the forge comes at a price. It is not gold that the forge wants, it is cinder shards. You will need cinder shards, lots of it. So, let me show you how to grind more cinder shards than you actually need. Luckily for us, we can farm cinder shards right here in the volcano. All you need to do is get a good weapon and a burglar ring. You can get the burglar ring from the Adventurer's Guild after you have defeated 500 dust sprites in the regular mines. Grinding out those dust sprites is definitely worth it because the burglar ring is just that good. The burglar ring will double the chances that enemies drop loot, and it will even cause enemies to drop loot twice instead of once. Now all you need to do is enter the volcano on any day. The cinder shard nodes will be influenced by your daily luck, and the amount of cinder shards that drop from the nodes can also be increased by your total luck. However, this is not where we'll be getting most of our cinder shards. We will be hunting down every magma sprite in the volcano because they have a very generous chance of dropping cinder shards. Yes, these guys are pretty annoying to fight because of their erratic flying patterns, but with a good weapon, you should not have much of a problem. Magma sprites have a 50% chance to drop a cinder shard. With the burglar ring, they will drop cinder shards more often than not. To make the most out of this, you should be scouting out the entirety of each and every floor to find and defeat as many of these guys as you can. Unfortunately, Monster Musk does not work in the volcano. Otherwise, farming cinder shards would have been pretty easy. On average, I can get about 120 cinder shards on each volcano run, which is enough to fully upgrade a galaxy weapon into an infinity weapon. After 3 to 5 volcano runs, you should have enough cinder shards for the rest of your playthrough, unless you like to play around with different builds like I do. The workbench is unexpectedly useful. Actually, once I started to use the workbench, I have no idea how I actually played the game until now. The workbench only costs 2000 gold and you can buy it from Robin. The workbench will use all of the items inside of the chests around it for crafting. It has the range of a regular quality sprinkler, but you can only place 7 chests around it because you will still need to be able to access it. For display purposes, I only only have 6 chests around my workbench. But as you can see, I have placed every resource required to craft any item in the game. Once you have set up a workbench like this, you will never have to go around looking for resources. And it helps out more than you think, especially if you're around the mid game and you're crafting things all the time. Okay, I know this one is pretty controversial, but if you don't have a return scepter or farm totems, it is actually worth it to stay up all the way until 2 AM if you are diving into the Skull Cavern. A lot of people think that if you pass out, you will lose your items, but that is most definitely not the case. If you pass out in the mines, you will only lose some gold, and the gold is capped at 1000 gold. If your goal is to finally reach floor 100 and you are a few floors away, it is definitely worth it to continue diving through the Skull Cavern and pass out at 2 AM. You will only lose items if you are defeated in battle. Passing out is really not that bad, because those extra hours will help you get that extra bit of iridium ore that you needed for another iridium sprinkler. While you are in the Skull Cavern, you should probably also just use a slingshot with some explosive ammo. It is only about 1000% better than a pickaxe, which isn't that much, but it's still pretty good in my opinion. Once you have completed the community center and found all of the golden walnuts, your next goal might be to try and get all of the achievements in the game. To make your life much easier, use magic bait to help you catch the fish you need. Magic bait will allow you to catch any fish during any season or weather, making it considerably easier and faster to get the Master Angler achievement. For the achievement, where you have to sell 15 of every single crop in the game by Pierre's stock list. This will allow you to buy any seed during any season, then plant these seeds on your Ginger Island farm. Now, you won't have to wait for a specific season to grow the crops that you need to complete this achievement. Now, for the most important thing on this list, you need to get your Stardew Valley glamour game on. Sure, you are a farmer, but that doesn't mean you need to walk around in overalls. Get yourself a sewing machine or befriend Emily to use hers, and then make your very own unique outfits that will truly make you stand out in the valley. I have been working on a Stardew Valley glamour video for about 2 weeks now, and it's taking so long because there's just an incredible amount of options and variations. You really can make your character look exactly how you want it to. With the sewing machine, you can craft all kinds of shirts, hats, and a few different pants as well. Most of the outfits can be dyed as well. Just place your shirt into the sewing machine and then use a rainbow shell to bring up a window that will literally let you pick any color that you want. There is just so much freedom with this. You can also change the way your shoes look without losing their stats. Place the shoe with the look you like at the bottom of the sewing machine, and place the shoe with the stats you need at the top. After the sewing machine is done, your shoes will look good and still give you those good defense stats. Don't underestimate the power of glamour. Do you already have a unique, cute character? Consider joining my Discord and sharing a screenshot of your character. Bonus points if you have a matching hat on your horse. If you haven't already hit that subscribe button, you should absolutely do it for tons of videos on your own and my favorite game. And that brings us to the end of the video. Hopefully some of these tips have helped you out, and if you have any of your own tips, please do consider dropping them in the comments below. I would benefit from these tips, and so would a bunch of other players. But for now, I will see you in the next video.